What is going on, guys? TheWaffle here. Welcome back to some more ARK Survival Evolved. Now, as you can see right in front of me, I have an ARGENTAVIS or something like that. I'm going to have to look up the correct pronunciation. But I'm currently taming an ARGENTAVIS or something like that. And over here, I have a pteranodon kind of stuck in this crevice, and I'm taming both of them right now. And the pteranodon's almost done taming. Huh, not bad. As you can see, the pteranodon's actually up to 107 levels, plus 19 levels whenever he gets tamed to us. What's the ARGENTAVIS at currently? It's like 30-something, and I think it's a female. 33, and it gets plus 10 levels. Man, this thing is old. Man, I'm dehydrated. Man, that ARGENTAVIS thing is, like, hardcore, like... There you go. It's like... hardcore, like, reflecty. It's like all bright and stuff. So I'm taming those two flying creatures, but I also already tamed, that's right, a Dimorphodon. Check it out. We have a Dimorphodon on our shoulder, just kind of hanging out. I think I could double tap E and he just, you know, set him to go fly anywhere that he wants to fly. But right now I have it set to where he'll, you know, follow me. So he'll follow me on Twitter at Waffleverse, just like you guys should. Oh, a little bit of lag, oh, there you go. But I think I could just kind of set him free and then do a whistle to attack something, and he'll just kind of, you know, go and attack it. So I think our Tyranno is actually really close to being level or being tamed. So let's see. Yeah, that's like a sliver right there. That is a sliver. Jeez. Man, that's insane. I have been giving it the cooked meat, the prime cooked meat that I've had on the SS meme, as well as our preserving bins back home that's just been kind of just sitting there. I've been too afraid to eat it because it's like pretty rare stuff, but at the same time, I really need to use it. So I might as well use it for taming these guys, because apparently this is really good for carnivores. So it says, "Sates your hunger and provides health while being digested, more effective than normal meat. Wild carnivores like this meat a lot." So that's the reason why I gave it to them, and it seems to be taming them rather quickly. Oh, there we go, we have the pteranodon. Holy that. So we have the pteranodon tamed to us now. Hashtag pteranodon tamed. Set him to follow. There we go, enable following, and hopefully he's going to get out of that crevice. Oh, there we go. Whew. Let's get a good look at him. Not bad. Kind of has like a black and teal color to him. Huh. That's kind of cool. How close is the ARGENTAVIS thing to being tamed to us? Probably butchering the pronunciation. About halfway done. So I think what I'm going to do now is make sure this thing has enough. Make sure it has enough torpor. Probably head back home real quick. Make a saddle and ride around our pteranodon and stuff like that. Either way, I just wanted to record this real quick clip before starting the episode to let you guys know that I am taming these guys. I don't know if I'm going to be taming another Utah Raptor. Those guys seem to be pretty rare, as well as the Stegosaurus. I don't know if I'll get them between, you know, before this episode, because there is an absolute ton of stuff I have to do, and I have to get an episode out for Sunday, so I might have to put that off until later, but I just wanted to show you guys that I have these guys nice and tamed to me, and I'm currently taming the ARGENTAVIS over here as well, so definitely look forward to that in today's episode. But without any further ado, I guess we'll just start the intro and start episode 27 or 28 or 29 of ARK Survival Evolved. Oh, I don't even know what episode it is. Oh boy, look at this, we got an ARGENTAVIS here, and I guess it's finally tamed to us. Alright, well there you go. I don't know if I want to read the dossier anymore. I don't really like having that little notebook thing. Ooh, look at this, there it is right there. Ooh, there you go. Little bit of lag, but look at this, all the way at the 43 levels. What's the carry weight on this thing, actually? Because I have a lot of wood in my inventory. Not bad. About 300 pounds. All right, well, it's already following me, so might as well make it, you know, carry all this trash I've got. Yeah, look at that. Still has about 100 pounds left of carry weight, so not bad. All right, so it's set to follow me. Yeah, set to follow me. I already have a Pteranodon saddle, and look at this. This Pteranodon has an absolute ton of stamina. Look at this. Yeah, 990 stamina, and our orange ARGENTAVIS is following us, so that's good. Anyways, let's head back home and maybe make a saddle for that little guy. You know, leave some comments down below. What should we name our ARGENTAVIS, if that's even how you pronounce it? It seems to be flying rather slowly, but I think it's more of a, like, it's not supposed to be like a speed flyer, you know? I also learned that there is a trick that the Pteranodon can do where it can, oh, whoops, that's the wrong button. There goes my Dimorphodon, but it's still following me. But I could do this, and he does a casual barrel roll. I do a barrel roll. Ah, there you go. And he kind of like speeds up and like swirls like that. That's really cool. I like that. All right, so how about you land there? And our Dimorphodon and our Argentavis will catch up here in a bit. But let's... Argentavis has a level up, so let's get ourselves a level up for that guy. What do we want to give him? Movement speed is decently slow. Weight's pretty good, about 400 pounds of carry weight. Let's give it movement speed. I don't think that really did anything noticeable, to be quite honest, but let's get all that back. And let's just give it regular raw meat and put the prime meat, or whatever it's called, put that back inside of the preserving bin. Let's put that back over here. I don't even think there's room inside of that one. I have been cooking some of my raw meat, so we have an absolute ton of cooked meat, and what's really good is that, you know, raw meat stacks up to 20 raw meat at a time. There you go. There's a cooked prime meat I could put up. Raw meat stacks up to 20 meat, while cooked meat stacks up to 30. So you can store way more cooked meat than raw meat in a preserving bin, you know? If you kind of catch what I'm trying to say right now. So that's really, really good. Either way, upstairs, I actually have let's actually make the saddle. Do we even have that unlocked? Argentavis saddle. Yep, there it is right there. Learn the engram. 21 engrams. So let's see. Argentavis saddle. What do we need? Hyber. Oh, wow. We need a lot of chitin / keratin. So how much do we have? How much chitin do we have? Chitin. Oh, there it is right there. Oh, 4. Ooh, keratin. Ooh, we don't have any keratin or chitin. Ooh. Ooh. We have like none. We have literally like none. We're gonna have to kill like some carbonimuses or something like that to get some chitin and whatnot. Ooh. So we can't ride the Argentavis thing, or Argentavis, whatever it's called. Can't ride that thing just yet. So that's kind of unfortunate. But I suppose we could kind of fly around and kill a bunch of carbonimi, if that's even what they're called, like the plural version of it, and, you know, get a lot of keratin and whatnot to be able to, you know, ride around. So, let's see. Where is it? Oh, there it is right there. Oh, wow, it's like on my roof. It's like on my patio roof. And let's... Oh, come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Hold, there you go. Disable following. Yeah, there you go. Disable following. And wandering is not enabled. Man, this thing is huge. Sheesh. And wandering is not enabled. Okay, that's good. Whew. So I think he's just going to kind of stay there now. Stay there forever. Either way, Dimorphodon, get back on my shoulder. There you go. Anyways, looks like, ooh, look at that. Our Tyrannon has a level up as well. I do need to go back like 10 or so episodes ago. Look at the comments where you guys asked, or where I asked, you know, what we should name our first Tyrannon, where I found out about Spyro. So I should definitely go back and find out what we should name this guy by those comments. So let's see, what do we want to level up on this? Stamina's pretty much maxed out. Let's just face the facts. Movement speed is pretty good. Weight. I feel like if we want a flying creature that can carry a lot of stuff, that's what the Argentavis is for. Let's do movement speed on that. There you go. And upstairs, you know, a couple episodes ago, we worked on the roof as well as the attic of our house here. Well, if we go upstairs, if I can go upstairs, with this Argentavis, like, wings that are in the way, I can't even climb. I literally cannot even climb. Can I, like, climb my own ladder, please? Please? I can't go up there. Oh, my God. Okay. Well, let's go over here. Let's get some of the charcoal out of here, because charcoal is taking up so much room. Let's put up all the wood. There you go. Put up all the wood and thatch. And that's pretty much it. Oh, flint. There you go. Put up some of that dirty water. And I guess I can just go throw some of the charcoal over here at our storage area. Anyways, between this episode and last episode, I actually went on a raft to the Crystal Mountain, mined a lot of, not really a lot of crystals, more so a lot of metal, and I've been smelting it. You might have noticed that my like smeltery thing has been, it's been blazing away lately. Let's go check up on it. How much stuff is ready? 45 more metal, not bad, respectable amount. Huh. All right, let's put more wood there. There you go. That should be enough wood to cook all of that metal. Look at that. 200, 400, 440, 440, what is that? 514? 514 more metal. And of course, you need to divide that by 2 because you need 2 metal to get 1 metal ingot. Oh, where am I going? Oh, yeah, I'm putting up the charcoal. But 514, that's going to get us, what? 257? Oh, whoops, that's not what goes there. There you go. 257 more metal? That's a really good amount. Now, between this episode and last episode, I also, you know, on the way and to and fro the Crystal Mountain, I found a lot of supply drops, and I got some, the pistol I think we got on camera. I think we got the scope attachment on camera as well, but we also have this long neck rifle I got. So that's good. We also got some ammunition, shotgun ammo there, simple shotgun ammo there as well, simple rifle ammo. So we are pretty decked out when it comes to, you know, guns. So we could probably carry this long neck rifle with some long neck rifle, like, you know, ammunition. There you go. Maybe get a scope. Let's get the scope. Yeah, let's get the scope and attach it to the rifle. Yeah, there you go. So let's get that. Let's put that on 7. Let's see. There we go. Ooh. Ooh, load that bad boy up. Now, of course, it is a rifle. So it's not going to have the, like, most MLG reload time. Ooh, look at this scope. I can hit that carbone. I wonder if I can even hit that. Did I just hit it? We got a casual sniper rifle here, you guys. I don't know if I hit it. I think I'm a little bit too far for me to accurately hit it from here. Either way, do we have anything in our inventory right now that's kind of hit? Oh, I guess we have metal ingots. Yeah, let's put those up. Put those up over here. There you go. Put those up in the smithy. And we have narcotics, blah, blah, blah. I don't think we have anything else that really weighs anything. So let's go down. There you go. And let's go down the ladder. And let's go, I guess, carbonimus hunting or something. Like, look at this. We have our very first, I'm not even going to joke around when I say this, but sniper rifle. Like, oh my god, there's carbonimus right there. So it's level 20. Oh my god, I just pooped. That's a Dimorphodon. That Dimorphodon just pooped on my shoulder. Let's see. Shoot this thing. Hit fire it right in the skull. How much damage is that going to do? I'm pretty sure I can kill it easily with my sword. How much damage does these bullets do? I don't know. I'm literally shooting this thing straight in the skull. There it is. It's dead. 3 shots, and it's down. Now, I don't know what gets me keratin more. There you go. That's a little bit of keratin. What about my pickaxe? Pickaxe don't get me any keratin. God. Probably should have used my, Ooh, who's this? Probably should have used my sword. Level 77 red pteranodon. That'd be really cool if we had that pteranodon. I'm not going to joke. Either way, can I just kind of whistle and get my Argentavis, whatever it's called. I kind of want to go ride my pteranodon around, go find a bunch of carbonami, and just kind of end them. You know, just end their lives. Man, look at this. It looks like I'm looking into heaven itself because of how bright this is. Why is that so bright? Jeez. Man. God, I'm literally taking a ladder to heaven right now. What? Okay, let's go get on a pteranodon. Let's start shooting some stuff, shall we? There you go. We have a lot of carry weight on us. We have about 400 pounds worth of carry weight, which I'm pretty proud of, not going to joke. And around here, we need to be really careful, because around here we have that prime alpha Dilophosaurus or whatever that we, you know, came in contact with like an episode or two ago and kind of, you know, killed like two of our dinosaurs and like a million Danny DeVitos. So definitely want to be really careful of that. I think it's around there. Either that or like despawned. Pretty sure it's like around here because I passed it like on my raft a couple of times, but I'm not seeing it. You usually see a pretty large Dilophosaurus, but it has like a glow coming out of it, kind of like red smoke, orange smoke. But I'm not seeing it here on the beach. It must be more inland. Yeah, I guess so. All right, well, there's a carbonimus like right there. I suppose we can try and kill it because, oh, no. No, pteranodon. Let me ride back on you. Whew, there you go. There are a few carbonimuses over here just kind of hanging out. How about I land you? There you go. And how about I do a little bit of a slice and dice in action on these guys? Okay, this guy's not a lover. And two hits with the sword. Two hits and he's dead. A little bit of keratin. Not bad. There are some dodos around here. Now, I think what I need to do is double tap, get my Dimorphodon off my shoulder, and then hit this. There you go. Attack the dodo. Attack it. Attack the dodo. What are you doing? Kill it. Kill that dodo. End its life. End its life. End its life. Really? You're not going to do it. Really? You did it off camera. No problem. With like a level 111 dodo. There you go. Kill that dodo. Kill it. Kill it. Kill the female dodo. Wild female dodo. You're like flying right above it. Kill it! End its life! What are you doing? Man! Okay, I'll kill it then. Oh, I missed. Oh, that is embarrassing. Okay, oh, you have a level up. What do I want to give you? Movement speed? That's giving me movement speed again. Ooh. Are you, like, picking up berries or something? Look at that. You have some berries in your inventory. Huh, not bad. You can carry some of that meat, too. Don't mind if I do. All right, well, get back on my shoulder, Hater. There you go. There you go. All right. Well, let's go back to our unnamed Pteranodon that I need to go check the comments of, like, 10 episodes ago to find out what we're going to name this guy. Anyways, there was a supply drop over here. Green one I saw. I hope it's not gone already. God, I think it is. I think it's already gone. Oh, is there a Spinosaurus below us? I know there's a Spinosaurus hanging out in this general area for like the last like 10 episodes. I don't know where it is though. Oh, we have a pretty good amount of Triceratopses over here just kind of hanging out. Blobosaurus. Parasaurolophus down there. Oh, there's a Spinosaurus. That's not it though. That's a different one. It's like hunting a bunch of fish creatures in the water. That's definitely a different Spinosaurus. That looks insane though. That looks incredible. What level is it? Let's do a quick flyby if we can find out what level this thing is. Oh my god, it's attacking stuff. Is it trying to attack me? I think it is. Look at this. You're not going to get me there, Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus trash. I can't really see what level it is. Guess I'd go on to land and get my little spyglass out. Need to be really careful if like T-Rex is here too. Oh my god, there it is right there. It's coming. Oh my god. Ooh. Man, look at that thing. Ooh, killing dodos, killing Dilophosaurus just like it's nothing. Man. Okay, we need to get a little bit farther away. Let's go up here. Ooh, I don't think we have to worry about anything killing us up here. Ooh, we can kill those trilobites too. Those things have some pretty hard shells. Let's kill those. Ooh, wild female Spinosaurus 71. Level 71. Oh, whoops. Get rid of the spy. There you go. Now there are a bunch of trilobites over here. Remember that? On this beach, every time we came over here with a raft, we just kind of ran over like a half dozen of them. So maybe we can just go into the water, kill a billion of them, and we'll be good to go. So let's just land. Whoops. Oh, yep, you're good. Yep. All right. We're going troilobite hunting. They're usually here near the shore of the water. But I'm not seeing any right now. Where are they? They're like straight up. Oh, there's like a coelacanth. That's a coelacanth, isn't it? That looks like one. Coelacanth. No, it's a salmon. A saber-toothed salmon. Kill that thing. Whoa. I just got a dossier on a saber-toothed salmon. Not bad. All right, so now I can cook some salmon, I assume. Yeah, here. Nah, that's just regular raw fish meat. Huh. What is that over there? A dead body? Wild female megalodon dead. No, it's alive. Yeah, it's definitely alive. I thought it was dead. It had some, like, blood on it. Huh. Okay, let's go back into the water. There are dodos over here. Dodo Island. Where are these Oh, there's one right there. Disgusting trilobite. Nasty-looking thing. Kill it. End its life. Oh, wow, you're getting a lot of chitin. Getting silica pearls and stuff, too. There was actually a post on Reddit, like, I think 2 days ago, where someone found a trilobite. And then it was like in some rock and stuff, and he like slowly chipped away at the rock until he got nothing but the trilobite. I might show a picture on the screen because that's really cool. But oh my god, there's something in the water. But that was really cool, not gonna joke. Either way, see if we can find some more trilobite. Oh, is that a trilobite right there? No, that's a rock. It's literally just Dwayne Johnson right there. Okay. Ooh, I think there's a trilobite like right there. Yeah, I see you scuttling on the seafloor. What are you doing? What are you doing there? Oh, I see two of you guys. I might not want to kill you guys with my my crossbow. Oh my god, level 78. Come on, get over here. Oh, level 4 trash. Ooh, 34 chitin. Really good amount. Now remember, we can use either chitin or keratin. Both of which can be used interchangeably when making the Argentavis saddle. So let's actually get our... Ooh, yeah, we have a rifle too. What am I... I'm forgetting that we have a casual sniper rifle. I don't even know if this thing's good on... I assume not. So I'm pretty sure regular guns are pretty trash underwater. So I'm going to assume that this is pretty garbage as well. Oh, there's one right there.
All right. There's a troilobite like right there. Oh, nice. Nice.
Kill that thing, no problem. Even though it's literally at the seashore right here. Selling seashells at the seashore. Ooh, we're getting some oil and stuff. Oh, someone just pooped in the water. Was that me? Was that the Dimorphodon? Oh, look at that Dimorphodon's pooping left and right. Man. All right, well, let's see. Let's see if we can kill anything else. Any more trilobites want to die?
Because I will end your life if you get near me.
I kind of want to shoot a casual, like, megalodon or something, you know? What is that? Ooh, I think those are megalodons just hanging out. Oh, yeah, I can't shoot it underwater. What if I shot it above water, but shot it under, like, aiming underwater? I don't know if I hit anything right there. I just pooped my pants. I just pooped my pants. Oh, by the way, we have... Look at our chest plate. We have chitin for our chest plate. We got that from a supply drop. I think it was on camera, too. So, getting some really good things. Getting some really good upgrades as well. Either way, how much chitin do we have? I think we need like 100 right there. 103 and then 9. Huh. Let's actually look it up. Argentavis. We need 150 and we have 112 right now. Huh. Okay. Well, I think I might hunt some more trilobites and stuff real quick. Try and get some more of their chitin and whatnot, you know? Alright guys, so I think I have enough. Like chitin slash whatever. Let's actually check Argentavis. Oh man, seriously? I killed like 2 or 3 more trilobites. Huh. I'm a little bit short. Which isn't necessarily a bad thing. Of like if I, oh my god, coelacanth right there. Kill that coelacanth, kill it. Ooh, a big one right here. Nice. 1.4x. What does that mean? Huh. I don't know. 0.8x? Maybe that's not supposed to be there. Maybe that's just like a part of the mod saying like how big the coelacanth is. I don't know. Either way, there are a lot of trilobites that are over here. Maybe I just extinctified all of the trilobites. Oh, there's one right there. There's definitely one right there, but there are megalodons in the... Oh my god, there's one, like, right there. Trilobite right there. 12 chitin. And I think that's it. Ooh. Ooh, let's get out there. Let's get out. Let's get out. Whew. Okay, there's a megalodon in the water. Literally, like, right there, I think. Ooh, there's, like, multiple. Okay, we need to be really, really, really careful here. Oh my god, just pooped into water. Oh my god, I forgot we have the Dinomorphodon on our shoulder. That thing... It seems to just literally not even care that it's in the water. It's just still on my shoulder. It doesn't even care. Okay. Well, how much did we get? We just needed like 6 or something. So, Argentavis, we have enough. 156. All right, perfect. So, let's go home. Let's go get like the hide and the fiber and all that stuff that we're going to need. Because we have an absolute ton of hide and fiber and all that stuff. Let's actually get on our Pteranodon right now. And it looks like we have ourselves a nice little level up movement speed. There we go. Alright, and you might notice that I put glasses on them again, so there you go. Someone left a comment saying that you can get the glasses off the armor, because whenever you put the glasses on armor, it kind of like fuses into one item, so you have to like shift-click it off the armor to take the glasses off of the, or not the armor, but the saddle. You have to like shift-click it off to take it off the saddle, so that's what I did. I took the glasses off of the elephant-looking thing and put it on our Pteranodon, so now he looks all spiffy and stuff. Look at that! Even though the glasses literally make no sense because his eyes are on the side of his head and the glasses are in the front, so I don't really understand that. But look at how much stamina this guy has. He has an absolute ton of stamina. He is a real trooper. He's like maybe 3/4 stamina still full. We've been, you know, flying full sprint all the way over here from basically Crystal Mountain. Huh, that's really impressive. Look at that, he's still not even halfway. He's about 2/3. Man. Okay, Argentavis thing is still just kind of hanging out up there, so definitely need to make his armor, his saddle real quick. What do we need? Argentavis, we need hide? Yep, 350 hide. I hope I have enough. Hide. Yeah, we have enough. No problem whatsoever. Look at that. 2 stacks of 200. There we go. Argentavis saddle. I don't mind if I do. Let's get rid of all that stuff. Put up the extra hide fiber and chitin. There we go. Argentavis saddle. Nice. And oil. I don't know what we use oil for. I guess I have to look it up and find out what we use it for, but I currently do not know. But I'm just going to keep it for now because I'm pretty sure it's pretty good stuff we might need here in the future. Either way, oh my god, I am just there's poop all over the place. Dimorphodon poop, my poop. I don't even think we have enough like poop things over here for us to make like fertilizer out of. Yeah, look at this. This is completely full. This is full. This is full. I'm going to have to make another one of those things. Jeez. Oh, where'd it go? Where'd the Argentavis thing go? It's gone. Is it stuck in my house? It's like straight gone. Where'd it go? Oh my god. Pteranodon to... Oh, there it is right there. For a second, I thought he, like, ran away and we had to get on a Pteranodon to go find it. Either way, looks like this guy has a level up as well, so let's actually put his saddle on him. There you go, Argentavis. Oh my god, whoa. What was that? That was a weird glitch. And up, there you go, and put the saddle on. Alright, now we can ride him. Ooh. Not fast. But, like I said earlier... Okay, this is him regular speed. This is him sprinting speed. Decently fast. But like I said earlier, he's kind of like a pack mule. If you know what I mean. He can carry a lot of stuff. Look at him. Man, that looks awesome. Look at him eating like worms and stuff out of the ground. You're so gigantic. You don't even need to eat worms. Jeez. Anyways, yeah, you have a lot of raw meat you can eat. There you go. Some raw fish too. Blah, blah, blah. Most wild carnivores prefer raw meat to cooked meat. Yeah. Okay. Actually, ooh, I probably should have given it raw prime meat. What was it called? Raw primal meat. But I think raw primal meat like deteriorates faster. It spoils faster than cooked meat. So that's kind of unfortunate. But either way, these guys tamed relatively fast. Movement speed. What do we want to give them? Melee damage. Maybe just more carry weight. You know, so we can go to Crystal Mountain and back, and you know, carry an absolute ton of metal and crystals, etc., etc. I think that's going to be it, right? That's going to be our flying, like, crew. We're going to have our Pteranodon for speed and exploration. We're going to have our Argentavis thing for, you know, carrying loot. Huh. That seems like a pretty good synergy between the two of these guys.